Welcome back to our Getting Started tutorial series. In this video, we'll be explaining what an event in FMOD Studio is, as well as how to set up an event for your specific needs. First, let's get started with what an event is and looks like in FMOD Studio. Let's say I want to make a few different sounds for a game. In this case, we have an environmental ambient sound effect. A couple of different bird sounds. And some highlight sounds for our ambience. To get these sounds into FMOD Studio, we can just drag the parent folder straight into the Assets tab, and FMOD Studio will keep the folder structure intact for us. Next, we need to create an event, so our game engine has something to play these sounds with. If we navigate to the Events tab and right-click in the blank area, you'll see the option New Event and then a series of other options. These options are pre-made events that let you get started quickly for your particular needs. If the name includes either 2D or 3D, it indicates whether the event will be set up to play sound in a 2D or 3D space to begin with. But remember that any event can be modified to suit any situation. These options are purely a starting point. Speaking of 3D, the spatializer is an effect that can be applied to any audio within an event. This effect is one of the main ways that lets your game engine play back the sound in 3D space. When you play a sound in a game, generally it's either played in 2D space or 3D space. 2D space means the sound is played ignoring the position of the character or the object in the game. A game's music is an example of 2D sound playback. 3D space means that the sound is being played in a way that the game engine is keeping track of the character or object's position in the game world, and adjusting the panning and position of the sound to appear closer or further away. Generally, you can think of it like this. 2D space is similar to listening to a sound on headphones. 3D space is how sound normally works day to day. You hear a sound originating from a certain point, which then gets louder or quieter the closer or further from the sound you are. We'll go over how to set up and change the settings on the FMOD Spatializer in a later video. But for now, just know that when you choose a pre-made event that has 2D in the name, it means it's creating an event without an FMOD Spatializer. When you choose a pre-made event that has the word 3D, an event will be created that has the FMOD Spatializer. You can always add or remove the spatializer at a later date if needed. For now, we can right-click in the Events tab and select 3D Action from some of our pre-made events, and call it Ambience. This will create a 3D event with an action sheet that we can use for our ambient sounds. You'll notice that because we selected a pre-made event with 3D in the name, our new event has an FMOD spatializer added to the master track. Before we start adding sounds, let's go over the event interface. As we mentioned in our previous video, an event in FMOD Studio is a unit of sound that can be played, controlled, and stopped from inside the game engine. To put it simply, an event is what a game engine plays to make a sound. Whenever you select an event in the Events tab, its associated sheets will be displayed. A sheet is a way that you can control how your sound files are triggered within FMOD Studio events. By selecting the 3D Action pre-made event, our event already has an action sheet, indicated here. In FMOD Studio, there are three main types of sheets: the timeline sheet, the parameter sheet, and the action sheet. A timeline sheet triggers sound files in an event by moving the playback position left to right as time progresses, just like most DAWs. When the playback position line is over a sound, that sound will be triggered. A parameter sheet operates in the same way as a timeline sheet, but the playback position is controlled by the current parameter value. An action sheet triggers sound as soon as the event starts, either consecutively or concurrently, and doesn't use a playback position. It's particularly useful for simple sounds that don't require the manipulation of the playback position. In our case, an action sheet works well, as we just want to play a single sound and make it loop. So let's just stick with that. To make our ambience event play sound, we need to add the sound to the action sheet. Just navigate back to the Assets tab and drag the selected audio into the action sheet. You can see that FMOD Studio has automatically set up the sounds in the sheet for us. We'll go over the process of setting up this ourselves in our next video, but as an overview, the container FMOD created to play the sound in is called an instrument. To start playback in an action sheet, just press spacebar or click play. To stop playback, either press the spacebar again or click the stop button. In this case, we want the instrument to play in a constant loop, as it's our environmental bass sound. However, you'll notice that once the sound file finishes, the instrument, and therefore the event, stops. To make this instrument continue playing in loop, we need to activate the loop instrument option. Just select the sound you added and you'll see its properties appear in the deck. If you left-click the loop instrument option, you'll see how it changes to a yellow color to show that it's activated. Now, when we play our event, the instrument continues to loop until we either press stop or select another event in FMOD Studio. So far, we've covered how to create an event in FMOD Studio and how to add sounds to an action sheet. Let's take a break for now. And in part two of this video, we'll look at adding sounds to timeline sheets and parameter sheets. Thanks for watching, and don't forget to subscribe and hit the bell to keep up to date on all our new videos.